PG from Sam Harrington University of Agriculture, Technology and Science.
Actually, one more. You know, my students have a request for sir. No, please tell this one. That's the fact that you have this.
Good evening. First of all, I, Sanju Sarkar, would like to convey my hearty pranams to all the professors, delegates, and judges, and the best wishes to all other participants. Following the words of Professor Stephen Hawking, I can say that ever since the dawn of civilization, we have prayed for an understanding order of the universe. Mathematicians and those like us who try to understand mathematics at the fullest, we are always busy in those attempts to explain some natural phenomena using the language of words. That is mathematics.
Come on,
to find out
from this one. Okay.
So to find my own place in those attempts.
What you have done, please explain.
Okay. To find my own place in those attempts, I try to explain blood flow using macro-hydrodynamic equations. Now, as you can see from the title of my research work, I have worked on a specific type of arteries, and there I have applied some non-Newtonian model on blood, and I have applied the studied the inclined magnetic fields effect on it. To explain the entire my research work, I have divided into six parts. My presentation is divided into six parts. In the first part, there is introduction. In introduction, I have given all the keynote and keyword points of my presentation in brief. First of all, what is MHD? Now, MHD or magneto-hydrodynamics, as it suggests, magneto and hydrodynamics, together they combine with magneto-hydrodynamics. And in magneto-hydrodynamics, we consider the flow of those non-magnetic but electrically conductive fluid in presence of a magnetic field. And magneto-hydrodynamic fluid flow generation can be divided into four steps, which is quite artificial but very good for understanding. First of all, what happens? There is really movement between conductive fluid and magnetic field. And that gives rise, according to the law of Faraday's law of inertia, that gives rise to some EMF. And that EMF again induces some magnetic field. And this induced magnetic field and induced magnetic field, they together combine and they interact with induced current density, and they give rise, as we know, J cross B, that well-known formula, they give rise to Lorentz force. And this Lorentz force is the body force for this field. Next, magnetohydrodynamics is okay. But what about the blood? Why about blood is magnetization flow? Now, it is experimentally proved that at any pH, any gradient of hemoglobin, which is inside RBC of blood, is electrically charged. Now, electrically charged hemoglobin is there inside blood. Therefore, at any pH, blood is electrically conductive. And if there is some gridded movement between blood flow and some imposed suitable magnetic field, then blood can be treated as a magnetohydrodynamic fluid. Next, non-Newtonian models, nothing to say about this. The model which I have taken is the Mayhem plastic model. And Mayhem plastic, it is clear from this graph that there is a linear relationship between shear stress and this shear strain rate. And yield stress is the amount of stress which shows the before the value of which the linear plastic will be treated as a plastic and it will get only plastic deformation. After that, it will start to flow. And if again, what is stenosis? Because one of the very important part of my work is stenosis. Now, stenosis. This is a schematic diagram of an artery, and stenosis is the accumulation of fat substances, calcium, and several cell debris. Those get accumulated on the cell of the artery walls, and that makes the lumen of the artery constricted. And what is for that is, though it is an artery stimulation, but still we can understand from this diagram, as is shown here by the RBCs, that the flow of blood is affected very much. And the flow of blood is affected, it gives rise to several cardiovascular diseases, heart attack, and several types of strokes. Now, it is a very major problem which we should take account. Now, mathematical formulation. For mathematical formulation, first I have taken, as you can see here, I have taken R in radial direction, Z in the axis of the artery, and here you see this M, 1, 2, 3, this is the number of stenosis with respect to some reference point. Now, here is the mathematical formulation, geometry of stenosis is given here. It is equation for multi stenosis, and it is axial symmetric, but non-symmetric. Now, everything is explained here except this psi thing. This is a very interesting parameter. It is the tapering parameter. It denotes how much my artery is tapered. Next is the equation of linear plastic model. As I said before, if the tau, that is the shear stress, is less than tau y, then there is no flow. That is dU by dr, that is the derivative of the velocity with respect to r, that is zero. And there is no flow actually. You will get plastic deformation. And next here is the radial stroke equation where I have substituted the body forces with one gravitational force and this Lorentz force, and here is the porosity. The force comes into porosity and it is indeed the porosity parameter. And gamma is the inclination of the angle because we have worked on inclined arteries, and theta is the angle at which magnetic field is applied. Now, boundary conditions are given here. Velocity, I have considered velocity, slip condition, pore velocity is also considered here, regularity condition is also here. Now, if for purpose of solution, I have introduced these non-dimensional parameters to make the equation unit free, then after substituting, I have got this one, and this here is this supplies velocity parameter. Next, after substituting the Bingham plastic fluid model, this equation is obtained. Now, from this equation, after several substitutions, several states, finally we get this equation. This is a known type of equation. It is Bessel's equation and it is non-homogeneous. Now, what is the general approach to solve Bingham poisson flow? What happens when the complementary function is calculated? Then, using the regularity condition, always the Bessel function of second kind is eliminated. But I need something different. I take the complementary function. Find out the particular integral using variation of parameters. Then I use the regularity condition to remove the Bessel's function of second kind from complementary function and approximate it in the particular integral function. And finally, I have got this solution where A is an arbitrary constant. Now, why I use the boundary condition of the one that I do ask it, there is a velocity slip, I get finally. Now, result. Why? Because if we get the expression of u once, then we can get any value at any requirement. Like here, it is the expression for pore velocity. If we get the value of the pore radius, then we can find out the pore velocity of this thing, which is very important since we are working on Bingham plastic model. There in Bingham plastic model, a solid plus pore runs to the side. Volumetric flow rate can be defined by this. And it is very easy to calculate since by approximating or by using the numerical measurements, we can easily obtain this. What shear stress is also given here? All of them are dependent on this u term. Next, for results and discussion, I have here discussed only the ur thing, that is the graph of u and r at several values of m, that is a Hartmann number. And it is seen that as the Hartmann number increases or the magnetic field increases, what happens? The MHD flow, that's the blood flow, increases, which is consistent with MHD flow. In MHD flow, as the magnetic field increases, blood flow velocity decreases. And in the second one, it is the angle at which magnetic field is applied. And it is seen here that as the magnetic field is applied, that is increased, the velocity of blood flow is not that much affected at the core region. It is okay, it is not, it doesn't really change, but it changes significantly near the boundary. Now, these two things together give us a very useful result, which I am going to tell you now. We can have control over magnetic field and its orientation. With the control over magnetic field,
clear its orientation, we can control the blood flow, and with the control of the blood flow, we can control several cardiovascular diseases. Maybe not today, not tomorrow, but someday in the near future, some will be able to use this mathematical formulation, which is obtained here, to formulate some device which will be able to create very magnetic field, which can be used in several cardiac diagnoses. Now, next, here are all the references that I used to formulate and to get familiarized with the topic. Next, I would like to say thanks to all those who helped me and inspired me during this study. I'd like to say thanks to my professors, and especially thanks to GLA University Authority and the Society for giving students like us such a very good platform to showcase our scientific interests. And again, thanks to you all.